This is the thinnest foldable phone ever made. At 8.9mm, the Galaxy Z Fold 7 is certainly impressive. But with every advancement to make devices thinner, we routinely see declines in device durability and repairability. Now let's get this out of the way first. It goes without saying that the likes of Huawei and Oppo have gone bigger and better with technologies like trifold screens and silicon carbon batteries that provide higher energy density. But where size is concerned, Samsung comes first due to a lack of girth. But relying on slim and pretty alone would have us on very shaky ground. Beyond the 8-inch dynamic AMOLED 2X display, what does the Z Fold 7 say about Samsung's commitment to corporate social responsibility? Is this phone repairable, or like previous generations of Samsung foldables, is it an expensive device destined to end up in the e-waste stream? Let's find out. Like most portable electronics, the Z Fold 7 is powered by lithium-ion batteries. There's two of them in this phone, actually, and they're classified as consumable components. Sooner or later, those batteries need to be changed, and that means finding a way to break the seals on this phone. Judging from phone repair guru's attempt, the screen side is going to be harder to remove, so I'm going to use lots of heat and my anti-clamp to tackle that half first. Unfortunately for me, I forgot that Samsung introduced heatless back panel removal, which released before the display even started making a gap, so we're going to go through the camera side after all. This side of the phone houses the majority of the major electronic components, including one of the two lithium-ion batteries used by the Z Fold 7. After removing the wireless charging coil, the first thing I'll want to do is to disconnect the battery and remove the interconnect cable so I can pull that battery out. That means dismantling the lower assembly, popping several press connectors, and removing a few screws. In that process, I've netted myself the super modular USB-C port, a design which carries over from the S25 Ultra and makes port repairs an absolute breeze. The battery uses the older pull-tab style adhesive, which is supposed to make battery removal easier, in theory at least, but the reality is that these pull-tabs have never been much good. They need too much force and more often than not end up tearing, so it's perplexing to see Samsung discard their excellent enveloping adhesive wrapper like what they used in the S25 Ultra for what's clearly an inferior solution. Adding further complication to this battery removal process is how thin the batteries are. Applying too much force will bend the battery, potentially causing an internal short circuit that can cause the battery to combust. So we're back to using isopropyl alcohol and using picks to cut away at the glue underneath. It does the job, but this whole process is everything that's wrong with battery replacement in modern electronics. Our first battery is rated for a typical capacity of 8.55 watt-hours. It delivers less than half of the total 17.17 watt-hours the device is rated for. The lower assembly is divided into two halves, requiring a bit of isopropyl alcohol to safely remove. Now this device is actually still powered. The battery from the other half of the foldable is still connected and delivers charge to this side of the phone through one of these two press connectors. Removing the press connectors for the inner screen selfie camera and the millimeter wave antenna, along with a hidden screw underneath the millimeter wave antenna cable, releases the main board from the frame. The reverse side of the board houses the press connectors for the three main cameras, a pretty standard design for Samsung phones, but it also means a full disassembly is needed for any camera repairs. From top to bottom, we have the 12 megapixel ultra-wide camera, the 200 megapixel main camera with 2x optical zoom, and the 10 megapixel telephoto camera with 3x optical zoom. Now I'm going to turn my attention to that outer screen. I left the panel to cook for about 20 minutes before attempting this, but I still needed to use a heavy suction cup to create an opening for my pick. Whatever adhesive they're using for the outer panel is extremely strong and completely inappropriate for this application. Once the screen is up, I can pop the clipped-in plastic cover and remove the display connector, releasing the display. And now I'm hunting for a way to remove all the cables covering the battery. I'll need to work my way down to remove the remaining brackets, which are all covering various interconnect cables running the width of the battery. At this point, I've pretty much released the daughter board, so I'm going to remove it to get it out the way. And the last set of cables are coming from the SIM tray at the top. Owing to how thin this device is, a few components like the SIM tray have their ultra-thin PCBs glued directly to the frame. And here we are again, pull tabs on a battery that feels even flimsier than the last one I forcibly removed. I'm running through the same process again, and just like the last time, this battery needs three picks and some leverage using a spudger to remove. At 8.62 watt hours, this second battery is only a touch larger than the first. When combined, the Z Fold 7's batteries are rated for 17.17 watt hours. Now, up until this point, everything in this phone could be replaced with varying levels of difficulty, but the inner screen is a whole other story. It costs $589 to replace the 8-inch AMOLED panel, and while it's rated for 500,000 folding operations, this inner screen is still the most fragile component in the whole device, so repairability will be a concern for many owners. The problems start before we even have to remove the screen itself. The screen's bezels are glued in and the margins are tight. I had to resort to sharp tweezers, more force than I was comfortable applying, to get the plastic out, completely destroying the bezel in the process. After that extremely tedious task, I'll need to heat the inner screen again. To my surprise, the screen did lift up a little more easily than I'm used to seeing on these foldables, but despite that, I can pretty much guarantee the screen is dead. These foldable screens are extremely sensitive to pressure and torsional rotation, so realistically you'd only do this if the screen was already damaged. Underneath the screen, we can see what's arguably the second most critical component in the construction of a foldable phone, the hinge. Samsung has redesigned the hinge in each iteration of the Z Fold series, each year nudging towards a creaseless unfolded screen and a flatter folded form factor. As part of these redesigns, protecting the moving parts of the hinge from debris seems to be a key consideration, as gears are covered and protected and replaced with sliding mechanisms wherever possible. The Fold 7 comes awfully close to making large screen devices an everyday carry. It's a tablet in a smartphone's form factor, and that's going to appeal to a lot of people. But portability shouldn't come at the expense of longevity, and that's where the Fold 7 really falls short. While the general disassembly might be considered somewhat reasonable, barring the incredibly strong adhesive used on the screen and the frustratingly useless battery pull tabs, the real repairability downfall of the device is also the reason you'd buy it in the first place. That beautiful inner panel is exceedingly fragile, and while well protected when folded, it can easily be damaged by dirt particles or even the slightest amount of pressure from your fingernails. Where screen repairs are concerned, expect to pay for a screen and chassis replacement. A screen-only replacement is simply not practical. Compounding this problem is what appears to be a lackluster level of support from Samsung in the way of spare parts or manuals, with even the now one-year-old Z Fold 6 lacking any kind of spare parts availability, while free electronic versions of manuals are still MIA. With this in mind, the Samsung Galaxy Z Fold 7 achieves a 3 out of 10 on our smartphone repairability scale. Samsung does have the opportunity to improve the score by releasing parts and manuals for the Z Fold 7, at which point we'll revise our score.